So in this video, we are going to look at the workflow setup, right? We're just going to set up the workflow for approval. So here is the first level of approval for control is control owner. Okay, you can say whether the control is good, yes or no. Okay, so if he says no, then it goes to the issue owner, right? So he will be the what basically take the issue and see whether it can be fixed. If it is fixed, then it will basically push it back to the control owner. Okay, then if it cannot be fixed, it goes to a remediation plan, and then it goes to remediation plan owner. Okay, so this is how the general workflow works. Okay, so this can vary based on your company size. You can have maybe less number of steps or more number of steps, but this is general criteria where you if a control owner has the issue, he pushes down to a separate group of people who can fix the issue and then get it back to him. Okay, so let's look at this, how we basically look at where the owners are assigned and how do we kick off this process. Okay, so first step is we are going to identify where is the approvers. Okay, so let's go to master data. So we are here in the master data tab. Okay, so we're going to click on the organizations. Okay, so now we want to go to our organization, what we created, sub organization, open. Okay, so now sub process. Okay, user management, right? Highlight here and then open. If you go to roles, right? So you have a cross regulation sub process owner, right? So this is the owner. So now we have to map users to this owner. So let's see how we map the user to the owner. Okay, so this is a little simpler here than access control, where we have to basically map role to the user. Okay, so let's look at this. How do we do this? Okay, so same thing, you can also go to the other system, and if you go to the roles tab, this will be mapped, because this is mapped because of the BC sets. The BC sets we deployed has automatically mapped this. Okay. Okay, so here are the roles we need to add. Okay, SAP, GRC, SPC, CRS, control owner, right? Cross regulation control owner. This is the role we have to assign to enable the user to be mapped to this particular controller. Okay, that workflow role. Okay. Or the approval role. Okay, so we need to save this user. Okay, so that's how it's linked. Okay. Okay, so here are the two roles. Okay, the one role is CRS control owner, right? That's what a control owner. So control sub process owner, right? This is sub process owner. Okay, so we have to use these two roles to create two IDs. One is control sub process owner. Next one is control owner. Okay, so these are the two roles, you have to use them. Okay, and then create two IDs. Okay, but you also need these other roles, standard roles which are coming. Okay, so you also can customize the roles if you want, but it's advisable just to use the role as it is for testing, then you can customize once you understand the process. Okay, so these roles are also required. Okay, so now we are going to see how we are going to map these users. Okay, so we'll go back, let's go to hierarchy. Okay, so now we're going to go back, close this, cancel. Okay, cancel. So we are going to go here, open. Okay, we're going to go to open sub process. Okay, open this control. Okay, open. Okay, roles. We just go back. You want to make sure you put the right date. Open. Roles. So once we have created the roles, right, we create the user ID. So what we have to do is we have to go back to the organization. Okay. So we have to go to the subprocess. Open the subprocess. Okay. And then we have to go to the roles tab. So here you can basically assign. So now currently it's saying no changes of role assignments allowed for the past, right? So I have to figure out what date got collapsed, right? So I have to make sure that dates are not okay. So now I'm going to show you how do you assign. So you go to the subprocess, right? You go to subprocess and open, let's say go back here, okay, go open subprocess, okay, and go to the roles, cross regulation subprocess owner, assign. Okay, you can see the subprocess control owner, right? Control subprocess, okay. Okay, you can see that there are a lot of IDs appearing. So I'll tell you, let you know in this one more session where how do you restrict this list to only the people who have access to the role, okay? Right now it's basically showing up everybody, but we will restrict it to only people who are assigned to the role. Okay, so now this is how you can basically assign the approvers to the, so this could be Ram or this could be John, Adam or whatever it is, the user ID can be assigned, then now it is basically assigned to the ID, right? So this is how you basically assign approvers to the role. Thanks for watching the video. Please share, subscribe and comment. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you.